of how we survived in this country and how we will continue to survive. We were reminded of this when we went to Emmanuel African Methodist Episcopal Church in Charleston, South Carolina, where 9 people were executed by white supremacists. When Deacon Lee was asked how could they forgive this person who murdered their people, and he told us that every Sunday when they come to church, they're reminded of that execution. So we were asked, how do you forgive? And he said, he reminded us that it is our ability to forgive that has brought us as far as we have come as a people. He explained that when the master told you to pick 100 pounds of cotton, and you only picked 80 pounds, and then you got 20 lashes for the 20 you didn't pick, the only way you survived was to forgive. We've done that, and we will continue to do that. To love the Lord your God with all your heart, mind, and soul, and to love your neighbor as yourself. We love and we forgive. Number 3, we demand and insist that this country live up to its full potential.
Amen.
Make no mistake about it. This country cannot live up to its full potential without our full participation.
Amen.
It is our responsibility as leaders to lead our communities towards justice for all. And where the intersection of these 3 things fall through the cracks, it is our responsibility to fill the gap. And the question is why? Because we have that responsibility, the future is in our hands. This is what I offer you as I close. Embrace the gift that God has implanted in you. God has given you that gift to give it back to the world. Be the authentic you that only the gift God has given you can make you. Have the courage to share your gift in the authenticity of God's creation, and be willing to give all you are and all you have to give. Understand that there will be times when you'll need to move out of your areas of comfort. You're not just a preacher, you're a theologian, a politician, an attorney, a physician,
Amen.
A lobbyist, a scientist, a teacher. Paul said to the weak, I became weak so that I might win the weak. I have become all things to all people that I might by all means save some. Why? Because now is our time. We bring the learning of the past to the present. Our ancestors made a commitment with their actions of marching, sitting in, being beaten, having dogs sicked on them, being knocked down with the force of water hoses, being spat on, called every name but a child of God. They made a commitment that they were willing to die for, and they did die for us. It is our time. This is our time. The time is now. Our ancestors did the work they were supposed to do during their generation. Now is our time to do our work. We have been called to do it. We have been called to the front line. We have resources to use today that our ancestors didn't even dream of. The top of this list is social media and technology. And globalization has given us access to literally everything we need to do the work we're called to do today. Andrew Young, in 1998, Howard University commencement address, said to the class, the things the world needs are so eminently doable. It only takes the will and determination and the political commitment of a people to make it the kind of world we can be proud of. You are a politician. Politics as defined by Manfred Halpern is what we can and need to do together. We live in community. No person is an island. Everything that we do with others. So the idea of politics is important because politics is not just the competition for public power, but politics, according to Halpern, includes loving, playing, meditating, creating, learning, teaching, producing, consuming, risking trust and testing new experiences of life, and connecting with others to bring friendship, joy, beauty, and justice into the world. So we challenge the notion that we're not politicians, and we embrace a transformative view that politics that takes the whole person person into consideration cause us to stand as politicians in whatever way it impacts and influences the lives that we live. Coretta Scott King said in 1984, when we make politics a crusade, politicians will begin to understand that they must serve all the people and not just a selected few.
Amen.
The work that we are called to do is not easy. Frederick Douglass said, if there is no struggle, there is no progress.
Amen.
Those who profess the faith of freedom and yet deprecate agitation. A man who want crops without plowing of the ground. They want rain without thunder and lightning. They want the ocean without the awful roar of its many waters. This struggle may be a moral one, or it may be a physical one, or it may be both moral and physical, but it must be a struggle. Power concedes nothing without a demand. It never did, and it never will. Where do we go from here? We must become futuristic thinkers. As my homiletics professor at the Interdenominational Theological Center, Dr. Henry Clark, stated in every class, we must connect our yesterdays with our todays so that we can move into our tomorrows. Often people of color have been so caught up into making ends meet today that the thought of what might happen tomorrow or next week or a year from now is not even considered. Absolutely not thinking about what's going to happen 5, 10, 15 years.